take a new look at a single-player action game where a modern man goes back to medieval times and brings with it guns, vehicles, and all-out action. There's gonna be 100% destruction and a lot of things to do. Next up, take a look at a GTA-inspired action game where you play as a police instead.
Precinct, here to talk you through your beat as the ACPD's newest recruit. Welcome to the Rotten Apple. Good police work starts on the ground. Everything from parking infractions to vandalism to bank heists is procedurally generated in-game, so you never know what the day will bring. Your cruiser is the best way to patrol the city, but be ready to hit the streets on foot if things get loud. In this town, that happens all too often. When you've caught your mark, you'll need to follow procedure to make sure you handle the interaction appropriately. They could be a good citizen who made an honest mistake or a career criminal wanted for multiple offences. That's not to say you can't stop for a bite to eat every once in a while. Callouts can happen at any time, so you'll need to be ready to respond. Not everyone will react positively when you arrive on the scene, but you've got a variety of methods at your disposal to resolve the situation. Let your partner handle the paperwork. It's time to gear up for the next mission. You'll unlock new equipment in the armory as you gain experience. Tonight, we're taking to the skies on a helicopter patrol. You'll need to keep the spotlight trained on the perp to bring down their resistance meter while coordinating the ground response with the support menu. You can call in squad cars, spike strips, roadblocks, and more to help you bring them to justice. You can, of course, get involved in chases more directly. Call in the same support from your car, and don't worry too much about dodging these carefully placed piles of fruit crates.
Oops!
Sometimes, though, what's needed is a good old-fashioned foot chase. Don't worry, dispatch is standing by to assist if you need backup. Regardless, you'll need to make use of the city's geography to catch up with criminals and hold your own in a firefight. With the final perp booked, you're ready to end the day's shift. Averno's citizens will sleep a little safer for your efforts until tomorrow. Try your hand at policing the procedurally controlled world of The Precinct on PC, PlayStation 5, and Xbox Series X and S later this year.
Next up, take a look at an extraction ore that's quite unique.
Okay, I can see you're angry, but hear me out. You and your mates just stumbled into a rift. Think of it like a bubble of endless timelines, each different from the last. The problem is, entering a rift is a one-way ticket, and we need to figure out how to escape. Needless to say, I've been here for, quite a while. And that means I know what I'm doing. Right. The, weird crawly thing. Well, it's hard to say, but I'm pretty sure it's a fourth-dimensional shape-shifting being that can transcend the timelines. There's only one word I can think of to describe it. Macabre. It searches for life forces to consume throughout the rifts, and with your recent arrival, it looks like meat's back on the menu. Now, you're not entirely helpless. After all, you've got the Atomic Space Shifter, which allows me to pull your consciousness back to my timeline, whether you make it to the extract or die trying. But Macabre isn't your run-of-the-mill alien thing. It's far more cunning. It stalks its prey, at first from a distance, and then quietly, it gets closer, waiting for the opportune moment to strike. Of course, you can't just pull out a blicky and blast poor Macabre away. It's a little more complicated. You're going to need to be on the lookout for fragments scattered throughout the rifts. You can find them with your space shifter and bleed them from any timeline to yours. Fragments have many uses. We can craft tools and equipment that will help us deal with Macabre. But more importantly, I think they can help us find things that no one else has. And that's where the real adventure begins. Hey, this Kickstarter looks great.
Next up, take a new look at Delta Force Arc Up, which is a Battlefield and Call of Duty inspired game.
Follow me. Kingdom Come Deliverance 2 is a continuation of Henry's previous adventures, but the story's written in such a way that it's perfect for newcomers to Henry's journey.
Henry is a character that I think everybody can identify with. Goes through life with all these immense challenges, and I feel like everybody can relate to that.
Hans is all the kind of fun times and all the kind of ebullience and joy that Henry has in himself, but it takes a bit of accessing, and I think Hans really helps him to do that.
Whew. You were right about our stench.
Let's hope this water isn't too cold. You wouldn't want your pride and joy shrinking.
I'm more worried about it being too deep.
Come on.
The game is much bigger in scope. Original game, we had, I don't know, 3 hours of cutscenes. Now we have more than five. Regarding the size of the world, it's 2 times bigger than it was. The story is longer and much more epic. So previously it was about an issue of small nobility with bandits in their villages. Now it's about problems of kings.
This is a behemoth of a game in comparison to the first, in my opinion. I think it's got so much more energy and pace and adventure and action and fun and trial and tribulation and just everything that you could want from setting up the characters so beautifully in the first game and then throwing them out there and going, right, let's see what you're made of. This is going to be so much fun.
You can save the world, or you can help to punish it for its sins. The combat is also historically accurate, but we don't want to do that for the historical reasons or something. We want to do that for the immersion, and we want you to feel the sword in your hand. We want you to feel threatened by the enemies on the battlefield. We want you to fight for your life.
As far as missile weapons go, we added new type of weapon. We added crossbows, also some early firearms.
Kingdom Come feels like the good old school RPGs. It will always surprise you what you can and cannot do.
You know, you can be better in combat, you can be a sweet talking guy who talks his way out of problems, you can be a charming knight, you can be a thief, you know, a scoundrel. Anything you do will be recorded, people will remember it. They saw you do that, our crime system will react to that.
For example, when you are, I don't know, drunk and naked, people comment on that on the street, and now you can also reply. You can tell them, oh, I'm sorry, or you can tell them, piss off, man.
If you do a lot of criminal stuff around the village, people will start to be suspicious, they will greet you differently. So try to make these little things collapse into like greater mosaic where your actions are really reflected.
It will always surprise you what can be done in Kingdom Come.
Знайти в цих пісках те, що 20 років тому цитерські вивезти не змогли. Тут вам не Карпати, ні. Як стомився, ноги джерела, що не побачиш. А природа як дідька вдома. Тож майте на воці, не вскочте в халепу. І пам'ятайте, дипломатія – це наше все.
Запрягайте. Бачу, вже не... tribunal shall not flinch from crushing any insurgency or uprising with the inexorable.
This is a stark admonition to all who would presume.
Fucking time. I won't let anyone escape.
Nominally divided into two parts. The left one is where people have established their settlements. New communities appear there, as well as new trade routes and conflicts. This is where the main storyline unfolds, and PvE locations are situated. You will start here. This part of Pioneer is an adventure game with minimum MMO elements. We put a lot of efforts in our level design and use the best practices of narrative in dialogues. Moreover, we've created a special game mode where other players cannot interfere with you or your party playing. Oh yes, quests can be completed single-handedly or with friends. You can even have a dialogue with an NPC as a party. Explore the regions and gather info about the world and its mysterious past. Rest in any of the settlements, spending time in bars or playing mini-games. Trade for resources and try to gather as much as you can. Pioneer has progression levels, and after each level up, you get one skill point to spend on upgrading your character. This can make playing easier, but without creating builds, you won't have that big of an advantage on the battlefield. Yes, your armor and weapons itself are quite more important. Upgrading and efficiently using your equipment is what actually shows your progress through the games. These territories are home to PvPvE zones and clan wars. The gameplay here feels more like survival. Another player encountered here is likely to be an enemy, and the local creatures are decidedly more dangerous and ferocious. These two regions lack quests and are much less forgivable with regard to the players. You can lose all the resources you've spent time and effort gathering. At the same time, your death in a regular PvE zone will cost you just some polish on your equipment and a little bit of your pride. Your typical gameplay on the right part of the island looks something like this. You're gathering resources or joining your clan members to seize the production point. When you've gathered enough, you're trying to reach a safe zone using one of the suggested paths. Along the road, you're exploring some more unexplored places. Also, there are no guides on the right part of the island, so no fast travel for you. By the way, fast travel in Pioneer is possible with the help of the guides only. In addition to PvP, MMO fans will enjoy our raids and world bosses adapted to the realities of MMO FPS. After all, it would be fun to see how familiar activities look in unfamiliar conditions, wouldn't it? Pioneer is a unique experiment. The further you delve into the depth of the islands, the more the game transforms, transitioning from a role-playing adventure to an intense survival experience.